Now let's see about access methods or file access methods. File is a collection of related information which is stored in the secondary storage device such as hard disk. If you take employee file, then it contains the information about employees. If you take a customer file, then it contains the information about the customer. So we can define a file as a collection of related information which is stored in disk. In order to access the information which is present in the file, there are three methods are available. The first method is sequential access. The second one is direct access or relative access or random access. A third one is indexed sequential access. Now let us discuss all these methods one by one. So the first one is sequential access. Sequential access is the simplest method of all the three methods. Here the name itself specifies the meaning. The information in the file is accessed in sequential manner, that is record by record. Let us assume that we have a file which contains 100 records. Let us assume that currently we are at 50th record and we want to access 75th record. So assumes that our file contains 100 records. Now currently we are at 50th record. And what is our target here? We want to access 75th record. But which accessing technique we are using? Sequential access. So in order to access 75th record, we need to access all the records from 50 to 75. So first we need to access 50, next to 51, next to 52, 53, like that. So it is not possible to access 75th record directly. So all the records in between 50 to 75th are to be accessed. Why? Because sequential access means all the records are accessed in sequential manner. So what is the problem here? It will take more amount of time in order to read that record, in order to access that record. Why? Because we need to access the records between 50 to 75 also. Let us take the diagram here. So this is nothing but beginning of the file. So this is nothing but our current position head. So let us assume that now we are yet at this position. So after that we have to perform either read operation or write operation, record by record. Okay. Next, if you want, we can perform the rewind operation. Rewind means reset operation. So that means moving to the beginning position of the file. The best example for sequential access is magnetic tape. Magnetic tape means sequential access. All the records are accessed one by one. Okay. Let us see the operations here. The first operation here is read next. So it specifies that the next record will be readed. That means the content of that record will be readed. And the next one is write next. So write the next record. Here, after reading the next record, the read pointer will be moved to the next position. Likewise, after writing the next record also, the write pointer will be moved to the next position. That means the read pointer as well as the write pointer will be updated while performing read next and write next. Next one is reset or rewind. So reset or rewind means moving to the beginning position of the file. So the major advantage of this approach is it is the simplest technique. We have to access all the records one by one. But the major disadvantage is it is not possible to access any record directly. That means it will take more amount of time in order to access that record. So we can overcome the problem with the help of the second technique. So the second technique is direct access or relative access or random access. So by using this technique, we can access any record directly. Let us assume that our file contains 100 records. Let currently we are at 50th record and our target is we need to access 75th record. Then directly from 50th record to, we can go to the 75th record as well as we can access the 75th record. So that is the advantage here. We can access the record randomly without worrying about what is the order. Okay. So the best example for direct access is hard disk, magnetic disk. So we know what is a magnetic. A magnetic disk is, it is organized into a collection of blocks where the blocks contains the files. Okay. So the best example here is, if you take a CD, let us assume that CD contains 10 songs. Let us assume that now we are at the third song. So we are listening the third song. Then directly we can move to either 7th song or 9th song or 10th song. So magnetic disc such as CD, hard disk. So these are the best examples for direct access. Okay. Let's see the operations here. Read N. Here N means block number. Okay. So read 5th block number, 7th block number, 9th block number, 10th block number, like that. Okay. Next one is write N. So write the content into the block number. Write the content into N. Next one is position to N. So we can move the position at any block as we want. So let us assume that now we are at 50th block and we want to move to the 75th block. Then we can write as position to 75. So that now the read write head will be placed at 75th block. Okay. So after that we can perform either read operation or write operation. So position is nothing but seek operation that we use in C language. This position doesn't involve any input and output operation. By using position, we can place the file pointer at any position as we want. Here, position means read operation doesn't involve, write operation doesn't involve. Only we are moving the file pointer to the specific block. Now, let's see the simulation of sequential access on a direct access file. So, this is nothing but sequential access. This column is nothing but direct access. In sequential access, like we have a command like reset. So, reset means moving the position, current position, to the beginning of the file. So moving the file pointer to the beginning of the file. Whereas in direct access we can write as CP is equal to 0. Current position is equal to 0. So that CP will be placed at the beginning of the file. In sequential access, if the statement is like this, read next. So if you just read next, then what will happen? The corresponding record will be read it. And after that, read pointer will be advanced to the next position. Whereas in direct access we can write as read CP. So read that value, then after that CP is equal to CP plus 1, so that the current position will be moved to the next position. In sequential access, if the statement is like this, write next. In direct access we can write as write CP, and after that CP is equal to CP plus 1. So this is about direct access. Now let's see about indexed sequential access. It is mainly useful in order to overcome the drawback of sequential access. We know that the major drawback of sequential access is, for accessing a record, it will take more amount of time. Why? Because in sequential access, all the records are processed or accessed in sequential manner. Okay. Indexed sequential access, the name itself specifies the meaning. Here, it works based upon index. Okay. Let us assume that we have a 5000 records. Then the 5000 records can be divided into 6 blocks, where each block contains 1000 records. So the first here we have 5000 records. The first block contains the records from 0 to 1000. Second block contains the records from 1000 to 2000. So likewise, each block contains 1000 records. So this is known as master index or primary index. So it contains two columns. The first column is nothing but records, whereas the second column is nothing but pointer. So master index or primary index contains a pointer which contains the address of secondary index. So this is known as the secondary index. Okay. So here we have a pointer. So this pointer contains address of the secondary index. So this secondary index, let us assume that here for each block we can have a separate secondary index. So from 0 to 2000 we can have a separate secondary index, from 1000 to 2000 we can have a separate secondary index, like that. Here we have drawn the secondary index for 3000 to the 4000. So we can divide these 1000 records into 10 blocks, where each block contains 100 records. So from 1000 to 3001, so this is nothing but first block. 3100 to 3200, so this is nothing but second block. In secondary index also we have two columns. So the first column specifies records, whereas the second column specifies the pointer. So secondary index pointer contains the actual data of the corresponding record. Okay. In this example, let us assume that we want to access 3575 record. So first here, in order to find this record, we can apply binary search on this algorithm. so that the number of comparisons will be less. We have to calculate mid value. Mid is equal to low plus I by 2. So compare 3575 with this 0 as well as this 500, so that the number of comparisons will be less. Okay, if we apply the bind search on this master index. So here we have 3000 to 4000. So it contains a pointer. So this pointer contains the address of the secondary index. So here, which record we are accessing? 3575. So here we have records from 3500 to 3600. So in this range, the corresponding record is available. Okay. Secondary index also contains a pointer. So this pointer contains the actual data of the corresponding record. If you take the first one, that is nothing but sequential access. Let the current position is at 0th record. Then if you want to access 3575 record, then how many comparisons will be needed? 3575 comparisons will be needed. Whereas if you take indexed sequential access, then we can reduce the number of comparisons drastically by applying some index values. Okay. So this is the major advantage of indexed sequential access. So this is about access methods or file access methods.